Well, at 7:16, seeing one bee makes some people, like this one here, feel a little tense. Spotting a swarm of them would get anyone's attention.
Yeah, I'm a little bit nervous about it. But if you see that happening right now, consider this a good sign. May is swarming season, and with more people keeping backyard honeybees, you might see these swarms in your backyard. But don't worry, Denver 7's Nicole Brady explains why.
If you know how to work with them, and you're patient and calm, you shouldn't have any worry whatsoever with honeybees.
An entomologist at the Butterfly Pavilion, Mario Padilla, has a way of convincing you that standing amid hundreds of thousands of bees is no big deal.
There's 2,000 bees emerging every single day from the colony.
The apiary at Butterfly Pavilion has 17 colonies, each with 50,000 plus bees. Mario started the newest colony here from a swarm he caught.
We're gonna need to get a little smoky.
The smoke puts the bees at ease, but even without it, they're not aggressive.
A swarm of bees is just a reproductive process. They're actually the most docile they kind of ever are in a swarm because they're just trying to protect the queen as much as they possibly can, trying not to move around that much. They're trying to find a new place to live. So swarms, you don't have anything to worry about.
Swarms are a sign a colony got too big, so half the bees left to start a new one. And that's good. We need new bees. Population decline remains a concern. The Butterfly Pavilion teaches people to become beekeepers with a 5-part course.
We're more than just butterflies. You know, we like to educate people about the importance of every single animal.
If keeping honeybees is too much commitment, consider keeping a garden with flowers and plants that attract pollinators like bumblebees and butterflies. They're critical for our food supply. Of course, with honeybees.
That is pure unadulterated honey.
Just like that?
Just like that.
You do get the sweetest reward.